So this is the video for the Salingogon branch. But ko pa hiniwalay. Not sure. But sometimes it's easier to do if you do it like bit by bit. But so it's just the beginning of a modified stem stitch. If you've previously watched some of the other videos, you're gonna see a lot of this stitch, or you've seen a lot of this stitch already. So it's basically, but I think you have a better view for this one because you can more clearly see the unconventional way that we're doing the stem stitch here. So while that's going on, maybe you'd like to share a bit more about the Salingogon.
Salingogon. Okay.
Cynthia?
So, okay, thanks, Biel. So earlier we talked about the blossoms, the Salingogon flowers. Mm-hmm. So now I'm going to talk more about the tree, I guess.
Yeah.
So, okay, so since we're stitching the branch, right? So the Salingogon is a medium to large sized native tree that grows up to 45 meters tall. And yeah, it's high, no? And it's found mainly in lowland primary or secondary forests. So yun, and it's very attractive and easy to spot. So especially when the crown is covered with the light pink flowers that you, diba?
Those dainty pink flowers.
Yeah, mm-hmm. The cute dainty pink flowers amidst the new foliage. The new foliage is very attractive also because the young leaves, they have reddish pink leaf blades. Mm-hmm. Which you will see later, but right? when you start stitching them, pinkish,
oh, yes.
reddish, but right? They're not pure green. So measure,
they've
reddish.
Got, I know.
Yeah, make color din siya. So very shapes. Attractive. Yeah. So when you see the reddish pink leaves, young leaves with the pink blooms, sobrang pretty. Para siyang painting, diba?
May season ba siya?
Parang
summer ba yan? Like when the fire trees and the golden showers start coming out.
Let me consult my
check it out. Kasi yeah. Diba? The cherry blossom has their season, spring.
I know.
It's usually indicated. Summer eh. No?
Baka nga. It's not indicated here, so maybe it blooms here.
Well, if throughout the maybe year round, if anyone out there knows,
yeah, please tell us.
Please
enlighten
tell us. So we'll
I
know can, when to watch out for this.
Yeah,
pero, just quickly yeah. though, I did a couple of French knots.
Yes,
just for some of the. So those French knots, Cynthia, mm-hmm. those are just buds that are beginning, palang, no?
Yeah, are they? Yeah, they are. They are. So super small, tiny, but yeah, they are. They are.
Cute
so hindi pa sila nagiging flowers, yeah. Buds. And then yung pink flowers, they are found in clusters of 1 to 6 on their twigs. So tama lang to kasi we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, yeah. Yeah. Some of the flowers naman doon. So, yeah.
But you know what? Parang I haven't ano. Iba pa to sa. But there are other trees that are also malacherry blossom here.
Yeah, they are. Salimbogbog is another one. Baka we can do a future embroidery kit. You made that for your face mask.
Oh yes. Yeah.
That's
yeah.
the one.
Yeah, that's true. So that's so similar. Except I did it in one color, so I couldn't quite remember. Mm. But
good
for the Salingogon for here.
Yeah. So mas bright lang yung pink nito ng Salingogon.
So it's sana I mean,
you can if you can find it in more parks. I think there are initiatives now parang some people are reforesting parks with native species. So yun. I've heard of some NGOs that are doing that.
That'd be wonderful.
Yeah. And these trees, And a lot of these trees na itong salingwagon can be found near highways. So, di ba, when you go out of town, I'm not sure exactly where, but I've heard people talk about it. There's a highway somewhere in
spotting.
Yeah, you can do spotting.
Hang on. So in this section,
yes,
we're just doing the long and short stitch.
Okay.
So the long and short stitch, I had previously explained in some videos, it's similar to the satin stitch in the sense that you're coloring something in, except that the stitches are uneven, and the nature of the uneven stitches lend to blending of colors. So it's not necessarily a very fine blend for this one, at least, kasi medyo 3-ply pa rin yung ginagamit ko dito. But if you're a fan of embroidery and you've seen other super realistic like images, you know, portraits that people do, if you check out Instagram and see all of these amazing embroidery artists, some of them use only one strand just so that the blending is more seamless. Tayo medyo ano pa, medyo chunky pa, medyo makapal pa yung ano pag blend niya. It's still a bit rough, but I think it works pa naman for the for just adds to the texture.
It has handmade charm.
So here you can see the yellow meeting the blue. Blue, the green. What? Where's the blue? Yellow meaning the green on the bud. And there's a little illustration here down below just for you to better see how that came about. So unevenly coloring from the bottom, the yellow, and then doing the top naman. And then just having it meet together in the middle. That would be, that's kind of how it goes. So there. And it's interesting siya because like from the brown of the branch, it goes into the green. So that's a cool detail that I noticed with this one.
Yeah. And then the way you blended the colors, because it's like parang version siya sa painting, diba? When you mix two colors, diba? When two colors meet in the middle, so you use the parang jagged edge to make it look, diba?
Blended from afar. And that's how the long and short stitch works.
The long and short stitch, tama. So, see, I'm learning also here. Galeng.
Oh, I think you're gonna... Are we gonna encounter this again after this one? Parang hindi na yata. Oh, maybe in the banaba. No, that's one color. But anyway, but yeah, it's the whole optical blending concept is in play
optical
for this one at least. So again, there's a modified stem stitch, just as an outline. For here, is the salingogon tree a threatened species or a threatened?
It's not evaluated. So I think it's unknown. It's still it can still be. It's still around. Pero we can always, naman, diba? We can still tawag dun. Parang kwan pa rin. Parang we still need to propagate para hindi siya mawala.
So, yeah. And you would wonder, no? Kasi parang the flowers, these forest blooms are so beautiful. And they don't necessarily
them.
Yes. But also at the same time, parang we need to see more of them
more
in our public spaces.
Here, you know? Since a lot of them are, you know, are in the forests or high up in the mountains. Sana nga. But I think yun nga eh, parang there are active initiatives now that are doing this. So, yay. So
that would be great.
In the next 5 years, baka we'll be able to see more of them here in the city.
What's the scientific name of the salinggogon?
Salinggogon, it's Cratoxylum formosum. Wait, I'm gonna double check if I got that.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to ask you to send me the spelling for that.
Yes, Cratoxylum. Yeah, sige, sige. Cratoxylum. Yeah, it's Cratoxylum formosum. Taxonomy na, so I'm not really. Although I nag-attendin ako ng workshop ng taxonomy before, but very ano pa, super ano, different, ibang ano na siya, ibang discipline talaga.
I remember kasi parang as a kid in my old school, no, second grade school, so long ago, they had ano, biglang nag-initiative yung school na parang clean and green, and they started putting the scientific names of plants and trees and stuff, and we didn't really, you know, I mean, it didn't
attention.
Seem, yeah, I wasn't interested. It didn't seem so relevant. Mm-mm. But parang like when you're all grown up and you know these things, it's just so yeah. interesting. Exactly. It's so much cooler to know these when you're yeah, older.
I know, and I actually know some people who can, diba, parang when they see a tree, they can name the scientific, like people in Forest Foundation, yun sila Dayan, they know eh. Parang when they ask
I
them,
admire
what is
that.
Ay, diba? So parang galing. So yun. So sometimes I'm surprised na rin na I can name a few, diba? Kasi when you start, diba, like especially when you're getting familiar na with the species, parang ay, that's a ganyan. Pero mahirap talaga. Ang hahaba kasi ng scientific names.
Ang alam ko lang, akasha. Mangga.
Ah, mangga. Yeah, no, yeah. Diba?
Just how to identify na. I don't know the scientific names.
So, yeah. I know. It's so hard.
This is a mango tree.
Yeah, mango tree.
Hanggang din lang.
Santol, ganyan.
I think we had one in our backyard when I was little.
Yeah. Yung mga common trees in the backyard.
I
mangga
know.
Talaga dami.
Yeah. There it's bayabas. But you know, knowing the names, even if they're not the scientific names of these plants and trees, it's really ano, parang it gives you more place in a way.
Yeah.
It makes you more connected to where you're at or like the land that you're standing on in a way.
Yes.
Kasi parang when you're ano, oh, the video ended na. Okay, what am I gonna put here?
To be continued.
To be continued. Muni muni pa ako.
Muni muni.
Oh, but anyway, maybe I'll just save that thought for the next video.
For the next video, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
We'll go to the next.
Okay.